Manny Pangilinan's Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation has reportedly offered to buy the government's stake in SCTEX, that's the Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway. This was disclosed by the Basin Conversion and Development Authority President and CEO Joshua Bingkang. He says Metro Pacific has formally submitted a proposal to acquire BCDA's interest and take full control of the expressway. He adds a technical working group has been formed to identify the proper valuation of the acquisition price. According to Bingkang, the BCDA has 22 years left in its 30-year concession with the MVP Group for SCTEX. Chinese electric vehicle maker Zeekr prices its U.S. initial public offering at the top of its indicated range, raising $441 million. The premium brand of Geely upsized its IPO to sell 21 million American depositary shares at $21 per share. This gives the company a valuation of about $5 billion. That is a climb down from the $13 billion it was valued when it raised $750 million from new and existing investors last year. Zeekr's IPO comes amid a fierce EV price war in China that has undercut profits, leaving a number of companies to pursue expansion outside of China. Zeekr will make its debut on Friday under the ticker name ZK, marking the first major U.S. listing by a Chinese firm since 2021.
South Korea pledges support to tech giant Naver if it intends to maintain its stake in the joint venture controlling the mobile messenger app Line. Naver on Friday apologized for the November security breach that affected over 300,000 users offline and led to the Japanese government issuing an administrative guidance. The South Korean firm also said it is in talks with SoftBank, keeping all possibilities open, including selling its stake in Line operator LY Corp. South Korea's Science and Communication Vice Minister meanwhile clarified Naver is not being pressured to sell its stake, adding there has been no request from the administrative guidance of Japan's government to push a stake sale.
Hundreds of tourists stranded as a national carrier of the Pacific island of Vanuatu is placed on voluntary liquidation. The state-owned Vanuatu airline was grounded Thursday after the government ordered a review of the carrier's operations. The airline has been struggling financially due to high costs and as cyclones disrupted the tourism activity. It operates only 4 planes between the country's islands and to destinations such as Australia, New Zealand, and other South Pacific islands. The government-appointed liquidator says it is looking at all options to resume normal operations as soon as possible.
The Vanuatu government has indicated that they would prefer to resume operations as quickly as possible. Our role as voluntary liquidators will be to look at, to assess all options to achieve that and make that sustainable. So that might involve some kind of sale process. It may involve some kind of partnership arrangement with another airline.
Another cryptocurrency group is set to shake up U.S. politics. The nonprofit group Stand With Crypto has launched a new political action committee, or PAC, to raise money from its 440,000 members to back crypto-friendly politicians. Two other crypto PACs have so far raised more than $110 million this election cycle, according to the U.S. Federal Election Commission. The involvement of crypto groups in this year's U.S. elections comes as the industry faces some scrutiny following the crackdown on crypto exchange FTX. Its founder, Sam Bankman-Fried, who was found guilty of money laundering, was accused of using funds to donate more than $100 million to U.S. political campaigns.